let's try this heap files now. So let's see what are the files we have available in this. So let's try the heap 0 first. So let's try running this file first and see what this is all about. Okay, data is at this value and FP is at 0.50. So it's like that. And we are getting a segmentation fault as well. So to overflow this heap, let's like try what are the strings available in this heap file. Okay, we are getting some level pass, level has not passed, data is at this point, okay, and it's at here. So we can change these values also, and then let's see how to do that as well. So maybe let's like quickly do a object dump and get the function headers from this, just to make sure what are the functions available here. We have a main function and then there's something no winner, something like winner. So what is this winner function? So winner function is at 4878 and 64. So maybe we'll be able to swap these things and get it going. So let's try it like that. So basically what we are trying to do now is overflow. So let's run a quick GDB on this and see quiet mode. I don't want to jumble up my terminal now. So quiet mode on heap 0. Okay, so let's like disassemble the main and see what are the functions we have here. So here's ESP and EBP function headers, and then we are getting a call to this memory address, and it's getting called quite times, right? So then okay, and then it moves here, and also it goes to print early, and then we have that ES register called, and then there's leave and there's written. Okay, let's quickly run this thing and see. Okay, this memory address is at here, right? So 08. Let's see where the 08. Do we have a 08 or this register that I can see? So I'm not 50 either, I think. Okay, so you can't find it here. That means this data is directed somewhere inside one of these functions that we saw earlier. So probably it should be something like the winner function, or that no winner function we got here. So let's quickly try to do that as well. Let's see. And before that we have to set a breakpoint at break at this last return value. Let's see. Because if this ends, the program ends, we can't jump from that. So let's set it at that value and see. Okay, now the breakpoint is set there, and let's quickly run this. And while you're running this thing, let's like send something to this. Send some values like A, 4 A's, and then the program is being debugged and we started already. So yes, we have to do it again. See, and it says level has not been passed and breakpoint is at this value at 40. And okay, we are getting somewhere with this. So let's quickly see into the process map of this info.map. So these are the values that we have over here. So CMD line and all these general registry values. And then we can see that the heap is starting at here at right for this value. So then what we are going to do, we have to do at the beginning of this memory address, right? So we can like simply see what is the main heap memories is where our heap memory is storing the 4As that we sent inside here. So let's try doing that now. So 50x, and then let's like copy this value and paste it and see. Okay, so as you all know, this value, x value for this 4As is 41414. So we have this here, and then also we have to get the value of no winner function, right? So it was the last one, the nearest function we had. So my guess is there. So let's like see and add no winner and see. Okay, we are getting some value now. So is there anything related to the, yeah, so we are getting this, and this is stored at like somewhere here. So basically we can I think we can override this address and replace it with this winner address. So let's see like how many bytes we need to pass along to do this in order to override this heap. So let's like run. Okay, let me do that again. So I think I just jumbled up the things. So let's set a breakpoint at, okay, this is getting weird. So let's like disassemble main empty. So I'm going to quickly set a break at this value. Break, and this had to be pointed to this, and then run with OS. Okay, that got too much. Let's like do it like this, and again rerun this, and we are getting these values, and then we have to like the X, and then I have to get that value as well. So actually like before that we have to get the process maps, right? Yeah, so info of the process maps we have, and then we get to start the heap over here, and we are like going to x divided by 50x, and then this and see. So we have this 4As, and we have this value which is the value of no winner function. So just to make sure and refresh your memory, let's see what is happening. And no winner, and I'll also print the winner value just to make sure. Okay, 6 and 4, this is where it is at. So do we have that here now, right? So we have to like basically that should be somewhere up in the heap. So let's go there and see, like let's run with embedded Python command, say Python, and then pass C into this, and then like we can print something like number of A's, and this A's number will be like 100, let's see, and you need to have it multiplied, and then you can also make some addition to this and see where it changes. So basically let's like pass this value as well and see. So try running this. Yes, okay, so starting program with this and Python C and all that data is at these values and level has not been passed and the breakpoint was there, so we have to continue as well, right? I'm so sorry though, we have to like give this character actually. Okay. So the problem would be like let's strike it like this in single quotes and run it from the beginning. Yes, the problem was here, so we shouldn't use this double quotes but only single quotes for this. So anyway, so we just pass the value 4141 to this and then that means we are getting somewhere with this exploit. So let's keep it like that and maybe try to maybe we are getting something like I think the heap is overly overwritten or something, so just maybe have to reduce this value and see. So let's try it at 64 maybe. We are not getting anything because 64 would not be the where that ends. So again, actually we can get that at that point as well to get the buffer. So anyway, let's like try 70 or something. No, 64 then 4, so it's like jump another 4 bytes and see 68. 68 and the program has received this code but we haven't passed this value yet, so let's try another 4 of increments and 72 and yes, so we just pass this B value into this, meaning that A is 4141 and B is 4242, meaning that our heap is overflowing at this first offset. So we have to like get this memory address of winner as well now. So I think I got it earlier, so anyway let's like try to get it again. Okay, winner is this value, so let's pass this value into that like a little endian value and see how to do this thing. So actually when it comes to a little endian, you just have to write it from two digits and then backwards. So simply it will be like, let's say x and 64 and then sorry 4 and then and the x and 84 x04 yes the x she left, so x8 08 and let's try this value and see. Yes, we just passed the level, so that's how it's done. Happy hacking.